where we started the Purpose 2020 conversation in Switzerland roughly a year ago is with the notion that companies and brands today have even more and more power. You know, if you look at, and sorry Jacob to give you this example, but to look at Shell, you know, it's the same size in terms of revenue as the budget of Mexico, you know, or whatever country you take, you know, Volkswagen is the same size as the budget of India, and so on and so forth. So companies have real muscle. Now, it gets even more interesting. They don't just have the power, but they also have the voice, you know, and if you take, if you like it or not, the standard of the voice, you know, having 50 million followers on Twitter, you know, Nike still has 75 million on Instagram. So, yes, we have the power, but also the voice. That gets even more interesting. If you think through, if you ask consumers, who do you trust? Whose message do you trust? And then brands and businesses operate at the same level as NGOs and well ahead of governments. So if you have the power, you have the voice, then you have the trust. Yeah? But that comes with a responsibility, because people more and more expect, and the closer you get to the future, the closer you get to the younger generations, they really expect that we apply that power or that impact with, you know, with responsible care, really to do for good. And if you even drill in and ask the millennials, where do you want to work today? It's not just, you know, when I was a young boy, now being an old man, is where could I have a fantastic career? No, it's really, where can I have a positive impact? So it's not only that it's expected in the outside world, but also in the talent war, it is a really critical piece to get your positive impact right. Now, if that alone is not yet convincing, then it's also good, as we're businesses, to look how much value does it create. You know, so if you look at the right-hand side, it's the Brand Z data, which is, you know, the brand valuation database, which use real consumer data, not just some consultants thinking through, you know, which brand is most beautiful this year. There, if you look, valued by the consumers, if you look to the 12-year average, then brands with a purpose, or companies that have a purpose, have more than double the value growth than low or medium. And I think most interesting here, you know, to do it halfway, you know, do a bit of half-cooked work, doesn't generate a lot, it helps a bit. But the real thing is when you really do it really thoroughly. And that's why quite a simple definition. You know, it's ultimately the purpose is why you exist. Or a little bit more precise, you know, the positive impact you make on the people's life and the world they live in. So it's both what you do for your customers or your consumers, but also for the broader context they live in. So a very simple definition, but can be a really a guiding lens in, okay, what should we do? Does it have a positive impact on the people we serve and the world they live in?